As you take a look at this picture, there's probably some things that stand out to you. First is Orion, one of the most recognizable star patterns in the night sky. But there's also a few bright stars. We have this orangish star, this very bright one down here, and this one right here. And if we connect the three of these stars, it makes up an asterism called the Winter Triangle. And in this video, I'm going to teach you how to find the Winter Triangle and how it can be used to find many other constellations in the winter sky. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky together, one constellation at a time. Before we dive in and learn about the Winter Triangle, let's first learn about what an asterism is. An asterism is not a true constellation, but a pattern or group of stars that can be part of a constellation or a collection of constellations. So for the Winter Triangle, it's often called the Winter Triangle because that's when you can see it in the Northern Hemisphere, and the triangle is the pattern that it makes in the sky. So as we're looking at this photo, the Winter Triangle is right here. And I'm going to give you some practice with how to find it in the sky and give you an overview of the different stars that it includes. So first, here we have a picture. Are you able to find Orion? And can you point out the Winter Triangle? It really is one of the easiest star patterns to point out in the sky. And it's useful because it can help you point out other stars and constellations that are in the surrounding area. Another interesting fact is that the constellation Monoceros is kind of right in the middle here. It's very difficult to make out a pattern of Monoceros, but I've got a whole video on that. So if you want to learn more, go see that video. But the Winter Triangle contains three constellations. It has Orion, it has Canis Major, which is really cut off here, and then Canis Minor, which is a simple two-star constellations. And the stars that make up the Winter Triangle are Sirius, the brightest star in the night sky. We have Betelgeuse, right there. It's the orange star that's the shoulder of the giant of Orion. Orion is the giant. And then Procyon, or Procyon, I've heard it pronounced a few different ways, is the brightest star in the constellation Canis Minor. So let's get some more practice with how to find the Winter Triangle. Here we have another shot. This is a glorious shot because it just gives you so many stars. You can even see the Milky Way right here as well. You can even see some of the cool celestial objects in Orion, but I digress. Are you able to point out that triangle shape? It's really quite easy. It's right there, and if we were to point it out, there it is. And if we were to find the other constellations that are connected to this asterism, that's where they are. So we have Orion, Canis Minor, and Canis Major. So use the Winter Triangle to help you find those other constellations. And these stars are really bright. They're very, very bright. So even if you live in an area with lots of light pollution, you still should be able to see it. Now, finding the Winter Triangle is helpful because it helps you find where Orion is. And Orion is a super important constellation because it acts as a celestial guide. It points to so many other constellations. So what would that look like? Is you can draw imaginary lines across the sky. So I'll walk you through this. First, let's start with the belt stars. The belt stars of Orion will aim you down to Canis Major. The belt stars will also lead you up to Taurus the Bull, which you can't see here. You can't see most of the constellations that I'm pointing to, but we'll put this into practice in the next slide. Next, if you draw a line from here up to the shoulder of the giant, that points you towards Auriga, the charioteer. If you go from the star Rigel to Betelgeuse, it points you to Gemini, the twins. And then if you use the shoulder stars, that will aim you towards Canis Minor. So let's put this into practice. Here we have an awesome picture of most of the winter sky. So of course I'm speaking from the Northern Hemisphere because that's where I live. So all the videos I teach are always from that viewpoint. So as you're looking at this picture, can you find the Winter Triangle? That's where it is. Okay, you can connect those three dots. And if you want to know what the names of the stars are, there they are. We have Betelgeuse, Sirius, and Procyon. But let's go back here. This is actually another asterism called the Winter Hexagon, and that will be a different video for another time. But I always encourage you, start with the Winter Triangle, and then maybe you can find the asterism known as the Winter Hexagon. And here you can see the Winter Triangle superimposed upon the Winter Hexagon. I always look for this first because these stars are closer to each other. So let's use the Winter Triangle now to practice finding the other constellations in the sky. So if you can see that pattern, and then hopefully you're identifying this as Orion. And then from there, you should be able to find the other constellations connected to the Winter Triangle. We have Canis Major down at the very bottom, and then Canis Minor. And if we were to find Monoceros, I talked about this earlier. Monoceros is a modern day type of constellation that represents a unicorn, but it is right in the middle of that Winter Triangle area. From there, we can find Gemini. Remember, use Rigel to Betelgeuse to aim you towards Gemini. And then we have Auriga. You can use, this is, what is this star? Oh, it's called Safe. Safe to Bellatrix will lead you to Auriga. And then finally, we can use the belt stars to aim you towards Taurus. Notice the Pleiades and then the Hyades star cluster right there. And of course, we have to include Lepus. Lepus is a small constellation that is represented as a hare. So again, using the Winter Triangle can help you figure out where all the other constellations are in the night sky. It's very easy to point out because its stars stand out. So I hope this video was helpful for you in learning what the Winter Triangle asterism is. Remember, it's not a true constellation, but a pattern that we can connect to help us find other constellations. Remember, anytime you go outside, it takes time, patience, and practice. So I wish you luck in finding the Winter Triangle. Let me know in the comments below if you're able to see it. Thank you for watching, as always, and keep going outside and keep looking up.